I wonder, Dyros, when to go first. I'll go off the Melton first, because I may draw a black source next turn. Moxel Pool. Alright, so this is against robots. Not a good matchup for me. Not a bad one either though. Okay, I was wrong, this is Death Shadow. I'm just gonna name my enchantment, right? Yep. Oh! Okay, I know what he's playing now. This is really, really bad. He's playing, Lantern Control. I've got so many dead cards here. He's got one land in his hand and two unknown cards. The more lands I give him, the better it is for me. GG. Winning that first game is really important because post-ball gets even harder. He brings in stuff like escape, spellkite and stuff, and friends. Skull cracks. Revs. All of them. Searing Blaze gets the cut. Weird ass enchantment gets the cut. Well, it's not bad, but it gets the cut anyway. What else gets the cut? I'm not actually sure. Everything else is pretty good. Maybe the Vexing Devils, to be honest, because they get muted by the bridge really easily, but creatures are pretty good in this matchup. Got nothing to cut. Maybe the rift bolts? Yeah, okay, I'll cut the rift bolts. Because they're slow. Here we go. I can keep it. I like the Revolution hand. He might should take the Revity for the late game, but for the early game, he might take the Golem Guard instead. Yeah, that's the correct play. At least I think so, anyway. Nature's Claim. Blunted by land drop. Is he gonna give me my land? That wasn't very nice. Excellent, he has two lands in hand. Plus two unknown cards. If he does not play Ensnaring Bridge this turn, I think he just loses. Of course, Ghost Quarter hitting my Blood Crypt will actually delay me quite badly as well. Nature's Claim off the blocks. Plus one land in his hand. His next card is a Shredder, which is, yes, he's gonna lose next turn. Whoa, that was clever. Ah, yes, because he needs to, I'm gonna shake up his library a bit. He's got one land in hand and one unknown card. No, I already am targeting it. It's fine. DJ? GG.